The Spider Poems. Nothing believes Korea. Nothing turns into it and leaves your salt there. For it to fade, for it to ask casually, how's your Rothko? How's your thrift store painting? How's that? Nothing believes Korea. And believing it believes also that to be afraid is accursed, case-laden, peripatetic, inch-worthy, and glown. That's what it believes. Nothing much worse than that. Nothing much worse than for it to fade that way. In the second part, Korea disappears, becomes quasi-angular, like a filter, like a soup, like a spider, suddenly in your face, suddenly. This is the poem in which the sudden spider is suddenly in your face, like a spider. These are spiders. They are happy spiders. They fill the bugles of the nut-brained, beaming throughscape, most happy to collate. Other spiders live in the soft languish of the original underpants. Come, live with the spiders. Come, join them in the long hibernation dream of the original underpants, Mr. Jones. Some of the spiders are not called anything because they are happy. This is my new style. How do you like it? It has caused me great personal anguish. Franklin Covey and the spiders are coming down from the national capital carrying torches and poems. Nothing believes them. These are seeds being planted which are growing spiders. Growing spiders need milk to make strong bones. I have no milk, and so they are mad. I have no milk, and so they are very, very mad. Mad spiders all over the place. I believe them when they say, we are mad. I go out immediately and buy lots and lots of milk. I give it to them, and then I run. Once you've raised the expectations of the spiders you've imagined, you can then write things like, forms of forms are the reasoned mock alone in the ice factory eating whistling homeless quesadilla. And, be well, runt. And, what is love but a layered look-alike leaning on your bobble? Feel free to write these things about like those things. And remember, an ant the size of a rat may well be attacked by a hawk.